It's time for some Bio Cup time. Excellent. So the preliminary round is finished and round one has begun. They're exciting, they're good, they're nice. And so I am going to do an episode now all about how you can get a little bit more inspiration for the first round of the Bio Cup. And maybe you're one of those people who didn't make it to round one of the Bio Cup, and that's okay. Maybe some of the other mocks in this episode can still inspire you to build some cool stuff. So let's dive on in. Let's see what we can learn. So what is the theme for round one? Well, it is kind of in general, it's about nature specifically. But of course, there are a whole bunch of different sub-themes because everyone has been divided up into smaller groups and they sort of have individual fights in between, the groups of three or four different people there. So I'm going to read to you now all the individual subcategories for the theme of nature. And from there, we'll show you mocks that sort of relate to a bunch of those. So some of the themes include canines, felines, birds, rodents, marsupials, primates, reptiles, amphibians, arachnids, predatory insects, non-predatory insects, worms, crustaceans, mollusks, cnidarians, bony fish, boneless fish, echinoderms, bacteria or parasites, extinct species, cryptozoology, fruits or vegetables, carnivorous plants, fungi, flowering plants, animal plus animal hybrid, or an animal plus plant hybrid. So there's a whole bunch of them. You can see them on your screen right now too. Ben might have mispronounced some. He's good at doing that, but it's okay. But that's a whole bunch of the different themes. So let's talk a bit about mocks that relate to that. Of course, I don't have a mock for every individual subcategory here, but still, there's a whole bunch of them here that I think will still relate in some fashion and can inspire you. So let's begin with the first mock, which is by Jockson, and it's called Gekula Frog. So this, of course, would fit very well with the amphibian theme. And that's the idea. Just straight up building a frog. Great. Cool. Awesome. You know, you can definitely take a lot of inspiration from the real world. You know, you could go a more fictional route, build something from a book or a movie or a made up creature that you yourself have thought of. But sometimes it's nice to just build a straight up frog from the real world. Why not? You know, and this is a brilliant example of that. The eye design really, really pops using some of those bowl or sort of stool pieces that have appeared in a variety of different Lego sets. Some of them have even appeared as like flower pots and stuff. It's a pretty funky, really cool piece. And putting a ball joint in the middle there, it makes a great little eye design. The really strong kind of popping colors on this too, blue lime with that hint of white and red, really, really pops. Really, really gorgeous looking color scheme. It's very accurate to certain frogs in the real world as well. But it just looks nice, and it's really striking. It really grabs you, which I guess can kind of give you the edge in a competition. If the color scheme on your mock really does pop, it could be a little bit more memorable in that regard. Could be, of course. Depends who's judging you. But, you know, it's something to think about. The Ben 10 torso piece that's also been used here on the torso of this frog is also a lovely little addition. It's kind of some of the general textures on that torso piece there. Works quite well for a frog design. So definitely a good choice of pieces there. I also love, speaking of choices of pieces, the fingers and the toes on this mock, using some of the Exoforce robot arm pieces there as the toes. That works well. And then using the minifigure hand or arm pieces there also works really well. They kind of both have that nice kind of curvature to them that really does represent digits on a frog, which is really cool. I still love the knee design here. Those little cheese slopes kind of poking out as they're attached onto those boat studs there. And that boat stud is also the connection that forms the articulation in the legs there. Just is really well done. There's a lot of nice little tiny details in this mock that really help it to stand out. And again, it's not that big of a mock, but it's very accurate, very striking, uses pieces well, and gets the job done. So it's something you could easily do yourself, whether you're entering the competition or not, of course. The next build we've got here would fit very well in the crustacean sub-theme, especially because this mock is called the Cornust Station. So corn crustacean hybrid here, and it's by VB. And on that corn crustacean little fusion here, I love that. You know, this also would fit very well in that animal or plant hybrid sub theme as well. But what a fun pun, fun little play on words, of course, but also a really fun just creation or fun idea to have some sort of plant life like corn or whatever growing out of a crab. It's just clever. It really adds a nice little pop of color here, and it's just a fun detail. Some of the really nice stuff on this mock is the sort of smaller Technic panel pieces there in dark tan. Some of those came in a variety of different colors on some Star Wars Ultra Build sets. You know, VB has got a fair few here, and they form the kind of general shell of a crab very well. Really nice pieces there that kind of perfectly match that texture. So if you are building a crustacean of some sort, or kind of any sort of shelled animal, maybe those pieces are certainly something to look into. I still love the repeated use of some of these more rubbery spine spike pieces that he's used on the claws, as well as on the individual tips of the legs there. Those just work super well. And it's great to see them repeated too, because there is just that nice sense of cohesion and unity and consistency across the whole mock. It's really cool. And again, this is another example of a very realistic take on a crab. Of course, typically crabs don't have corn coming out of their head, but ignoring that, taking a look at the crab itself, it's very realistic, it's very lifelike. There's not really any sort of bionicle take on it, that, you know, adding more gears to it, or, you know, giving it a sort of interesting kind of science fiction look, maybe adding some additional, like, antenna on it or something. That hasn't been done. It's a very sort of realistic take on a crab, with some slight additions to it that take it out of that realm of realism and put it more into the abstract and into more out there different concepts. And so that's certainly something to consider. Can you do something very subtle that takes it out of the realm of the real? Or do you want to do something very major? You know, really change up the color scheme, give it an additional set of arms or legs, or, you know, have like a mohawk coming out of it, or spikes, or give it glasses, something crazy, something cool. Certainly something to consider there. So I like that this mock is doing it in a more traditional take, but yeah, never forget you can do it in some more not-so-traditional takes, or a hybrid of the two, much like this mock. So yeah, really nice work there, VB. Let's move on to the next mock, which is by Silvac the Mockist, and this is called Pit Jellyfish. So of course, this one could fit into some of the different varieties of fish related sub-themes for the contest. A great idea to do a funky-looking jellyfish much like this. This one was inspired by some of the jellyfish that you got with some of the Mari Nui LEGO System Bionicle playsets. They were a fun little addition to some of those sets and definitely looked really cool. So it's nice to see a mock of them, giving them a bit more life, a bit more light, and designing it so well as well. I love how he's used a whole bunch of these translucent blue pieces, whether that's the Nokama masks or the interesting sort of dome-shaped piece that I believe also came with some of those Bionicle Mari Nui System playsets. Nice to see that sort of very consistent color being used for the top there. It fits a jellyfish well. It's slightly sort of more of that solid deep blue, but it does have that nice translucent quality to it as well. But it's not as translucent as some other translucent pieces. It has a bit of a sort of milky texture to it, which I think fits a jellyfish very well. So great to see those repeated parts being used, and great to see that color being put to really good use. I still love too how he's used a whole bunch of those trans orange Hero Factory bone pieces as the stingers on a jellyfish. It's quite fitting, works well. And then there's this stack of dark green hand connectors, and then occasionally some studs have been put on the side there. That's a bit more of an interesting connection there, just in between where you normally put the socket into the ball on the hand connector there. You can actually attach studs on the side. It's a decently sturdy connection. But I love that little detail there. It does add a bit of a sort of underwater feel to that little bit of seaweed, but it also could sort of represent little bubbles or something, so it's very fitting. Additionally, too, I love the stand that this jellyfish is on. It's just a well-built little stand there, using a whole bunch of different slope pieces there in tan and a little bit of dark tan as well. And I think that's always a good idea, too, you know? Do you want to put a little stand or a little sort of rest that your mock can be placed on? Because as nice as this would be just having a jellyfish on its own, it's really drastically improved by having that little base underneath it. The addition of the seaweed, the addition of the sand really helps this mock to pop even more, and it definitely looks nicer on the shelf, and it's a lot less likely that it's going to fall over because it does have something holding it down. So certainly something to consider, especially too, it can give you a few extra points, I guess, in the competition if you just have something else to go with it there. I think that's a good idea for sure. So a really, really nice jellyfish mock here. Now this next mock here, it's by Aiden Builds, and it's called Bunyan Taproot. So before I read the name for this mock, I actually thought this was more of a unique interpretation of a jellyfish, because it kind of sort of looks like one, but it's not. It's a taproot. It is a rare and dangerous offspring of a bunyan seed, was what the description here says. But this one would definitely fit very well in the plants sub-theme within this nature theme. building a, as the description suggests, a sort of sentient evil root or plant. That's awesome. That's a great idea. And there's some really subtle stuff being done here that I think very effectively shows that this is a root or some sort of plant-like creature. And that could be, one, just the color scheme. The brown and green immediately evokes, you know, trees or other aspects of nature, so that's very fitting. But also the inclusion of the dark tan there very much conjures up images of roots that you would see on some sort of plant. I love that. All the different zamospheres there kind of looking like seeds. I've never really seen zamospheres being used in that manner, just sort of pouring them into a sort of container of sorts and allowing the interesting texture that it creates to form some sort of visual element on the mock. I think it's a great idea. You know, of course, they're not actually attached in any way. They're just sort of resting there. But it does a lot for the mock. It's a really sort of popping color, a really unique look and feel to it. It's really cool. It's pretty easily something you could do yourself too, because zamospheres are a fairly common piece. And especially too, if you bought a set that had some, it came with a fair few of them. So you could very easily do that yourself, and it's a very nice looking little technique there that you know, you don't actually have to do anything for it, you just pour it in, it's really nice. So yeah, of course, while this isn't a jellyfish, I also think it's interesting to note, you know, could you do something very similar to this if you were to build a jellyfish? Go a little bit more obscure, make it look a little bit more plant-like in nature, give it almost like a sort of weird brain thing at the top of its head, and even give it sort of little pincers at the front there or something like that. It's an interesting way of looking at it, that's for sure. So yeah, a cool plant or a cool jellyfish that's not actually a jellyfish, and Ben just got a little confused before he read the description. But regardless, very fitting and a great way of approaching that sub-theme. This next mock is by Patrick Biggs and it's called The Gardener. So again, this one could fit very well in the plants sub-theme. And I'll just read the description that Patrick put here. It says, "First came the men, then came the sores, then came the fire. The gardener begins his work by bringing life to the desolation." I like that idea. I like that idea a lot. And it certainly adds more life to the color scheme on this mock. The sort of black little stand that he's in very much looks like a sort of burnt out tree stump. And this little gardener character is coming in and planting a new life, a new seed, just to give life to the desolation, as he said. That's really, really cool. I like that a lot. It's a great little concept and a great way of playing with colors, too. The white flower really, really pops in between the brown and the black and the green. Additionally, too, I love the idea of building this leaf for this head here, just simply putting in two little pinholes there for that to represent eyes. And just getting a bunch of different slope pieces here to create what very much looks like a leaf for the head design there. Very unique, very clever. I still love the elbows on this mock as well. The way that those Technic axle connector joiner sort of pieces there form the elbow design, how they sort of curve off a little bit, and then you've got a little bit of that Paraka spine element, the little minifigure Paraka spine element. It looks a little bit like a root. It looks a little bit more like a twig, like a, you know, it's sort of branching off in certain ways. I think that's a very clever way of doing the elbow on that mock there, and also making it look a lot more tree-like, a lot more leaf-like in some way. It's very well done. So yeah, a lot of story to this, and some very unique concepts too. Love the head design, love how he's done the arms. A lot of nice stuff being played with here, and I think that's certainly something to consider too. If you can really pack in story and personality into the character, it's going to do you some good favors. So something to consider. On to the next mock now. This one is by Bahaturan, and it's called Rubot, or R00Bot. So this one here would very much fit into the marsupial category of the sub-theme list here, and I think this is such a great way of approaching it. You know, maybe you're not really that interested in building a sort of lifelike creature. Well, can you make it into a robot version? You know, I think this mock is very effectively building a sort of more robotic take on a kangaroo. It's really well done. And some subtle things that are doing that, of course, are definitely the way that the head has been designed there, using some of the translucent saliza visor pieces. That very much makes it look a little bit more robotic, like it's sort of a glass top that has all the little mechanical details inside. And additionally, too, I think the color scheme as well also helps with that. Of course, kangaroos themselves aren't that dark blue color, but it very much looks like it's sort of been painted into some more sort of sport-like colors with the dark blue. To some degree, also the white and the red as well could feed into that. But yeah, it very much sort of looks like some of the really bright, strong colors that you see on, you know, different teams in different sports or on like a race car or something. It's, again, it starts to paint a bit of a story of the world that this mock lives in. So I think little combinations of that. Of course, there's some other bits of grey and things in here that look a little bit more like, you know, other mechanical details or axles, that sort of thing. So there's a lot of little things here that are definitely communicating that it is more robotic. But what a great way of approaching this theme of, you know, building that, building a canine, building a marsupial, building a plant or whatever else the sub-themes were, but putting a more sort of robotic take on something that is very naturally more organic and flowing. It's a cool idea. I love, too, the boxing mitts on this boxing kangaroo here. Very cool. A great choice, too, to pick some of those minifigure helmets that have the printing on them with the stars. Could have very easily just picked a blank minifigure helmet piece, but the little star details there really work. That's a great little addition. And I love as well the fact that the Joey inside the kangaroo's pouch there also has boxing mitts. That's a very fun little detail and a great use of some of the minifigure boxing mitt pieces that have come in some collectible minifigure series sets. It's a great little detail and adds a lot of charm to this mock. That's cool. So yeah, a very, very fun little take on the theme there. Even though, of course, this isn't entered into the Bio Cup, but it's something that you could take inspiration from, and it would very much make it a more unique take on the theme, that's for sure. This next mock, it's by Remington Yost, and it's called Camouflaged Predator. I love the description on this one, too. It says, it's much easier to hunt prey when it comes right to you. That's cool, you know, some more, some of the herbivores that are going over to eat some of the plants and things, and little do they realize that underneath those plants there is a predator. That's a cool idea. You know, this mock here would fit very well into the sub-theme animal-plant hybrid, because it's literally that. That's awesome. I love this concept. I love it a lot. The sort of beautiful blend of, like I sort of said before, the mechanical versus the more organic and how those two can interact into each other. That's awesome. It certainly almost sort of seems like something you would see in a sort of post-apocalyptic world where it's all these sort of cities that have been destroyed or overrun, but the plants are growing back, and maybe these creatures somehow spawned out of that world. That's cool. It's cool. It's a really, really beautiful contrast between textures and colors on this mock. It's lovely. I love the nice pop of orange on the eye of this mock as well. That's just a nice little detail. And I also love how he's integrated a whole bunch of different tubing elements. You know, there's a bunch of them on the tail there, but they also sort of flow into the general kind of torso area on this mock. I like that it very much does look like there's sort of cables and pipes and, you know, energy cords and things that very much feed into this mock. And, you know, power courses through it or something, or it's kind of like internal organs almost. It's just an interesting way that it's been designed, but it also does add a nice sort of organic sense to this because, you know, naturally those pipe pieces have that more sort of rounded shape to them. And so, naturally, some of those more rounded shapes are seen there on, like, the legs and other areas of the torso and tail, of course, as well. So it not only aesthetically looks nice because of the texture that it provides and, you know, tubing very much fitting into a more mechanical style creature or beast here, but it also does help to shape things to make it look more rounded and organic as well. So it's very nicely done. And very nicely done to everybody I featured today, and nicely done to everybody who made it into round one. And of course, hey, if you didn't make it into round one, don't stress, because you didn't make it into round one. That's okay. You can still pick up a few more pieces now and get building. It doesn't need to be for the Bio Cup. And maybe this theme here for round one has still inspired you and you thought, you know what, I am going to build something that fits into one of these sub-themes here. Of course, I'm not going to enter it into the cup, but I'm going to build it anyway. Why not? Could be a fun thing to do. But that's it for this episode of the Bio Cup coverage. Be sure to check the links in the description below so you can check out even more stuff with the Bio Cup Flickr group or the Bio Cup Discord server. Additionally, you can also check the links in the description to the mocks that you saw in today's episode. Be sure to check out some of the other stuff they've done. And also check the links below to some of my social media as well if you are interested. But anyway, that's it for now, guys. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye. For now.